Google Analytics for Firebase is a powerful part of the Firebase suite, giving you a free app measurement solution that provides insight on app usage and user engagement. Like any analytics suite, it helps you understand how your users are interacting with your product, and from the data it gathers, you can derive which parts of your product delight and excite them, and which parts of your product need to be improved. But what if you could go further? What if you could learn ahead of time which users are most likely to become inactive, or which users are likely to make a future in-app purchase? And what if you could create a dynamic user group of them, which you could then use with other parts of Firebase, such as notifications or remote config? And what if that user group was updated for you on a daily basis? Well, that's what Firebase Predictions is all about. It uses advanced machine learning algorithms on your app data to determine who is likely to churn, who is likely to spend, or who is likely to meet custom analytics criteria in the near future. Let's take a look. Here's the prediction screen on the Firebase console. The first, churn, detects which users have a likelihood of churning in the next 7 days. In this case, 26% or 2,300 of this app's users may churn. Over a quarter of the app's users are likely to stop engaging with the app in the next 7 days, and that's information that you probably want to know. Predictions creates a dynamic user group that's updated daily. You can target this group using a notification to encourage them to stay with some type of incentive. Or you could use remote config to personalize the in-app experience for this user group by setting a global value in your app. Maybe it's a standard discount in an e-commerce app or a difficulty level in a game. Then this user group would get that value and that could entice them to stay. Note also that there's a risk tolerance setting that you can use. A high tolerance value means that you broaden the net. You'll be able to reach more users, but you'll have more false positives. Similarly, a low tolerance means that you tighten the net. You'll get fewer users, but of course you'll also get fewer false positives. The other two default predictions are spend and not spend. As their name suggests, these will give you groups of users who have been predicted to either spend money through in-app purchases or not to do so. Again, this gives you a great tool to enhance your users' experience as well as to grow the revenue of your business. For example, for the user group that is predicted to make in-app purchases, you could use remote config to show them higher value purchases. And for the user group that is not likely to make an in-app purchase, you could, for example, show them ads instead, or you could send them notifications with offers and discounts that might encourage them to do so. You aren't limited to these three cards, of course. You can create your own custom predictions based on any custom conversion event that you log from your app. So for example, if I have a game that has a lot of users and I have analytics tracked in this game, such as maybe users that have retried a level and which level they've retried, I can start creating predictions for that. And here's how I would do that. Here you can see I create a prediction on this analytics event and I'll call it retry level. It will give me a collection of users who predictions deems are likely to retry a level. Now with that group of users, I can do something interesting. For example, maybe tweak the difficulty via remote config so that they don't have to keep retrying. Then I'll have a card on my console that I can use to act on. And over time, using analytics, I will see what's happening to these users. A lot of people are retrying levels in my game, or maybe most people are progressing smoothly through my game. So that's Firebase Predictions, an analytics-driven product that uses machine learning to segment your users by predicted behavior so you can make product decisions that enhance your growth strategies and your users' experience. You can learn more about this and the rest of Firebase at firebase.google.com.